Hello scholars, today we are going to start chapter number 3, playing with numbers. So in this chapter, today we will learn about factors, multiples, odd and even numbers, prime numbers, composite numbers. So first see factors. Factors are the numbers which are exact divisor of any number. Here you can see the examples 14 divided by 2 and 15 divided by 2. When I divided 14 by 2, then the remainder is 0 and quotient is 7. So 7 and 2 are exact divisors of 14. In next example, remainder is 1. So in that case, 2 and 7 are not divisors of 15 because they are not giving remainder 0. Next is multiples. A multiple of a number is the number multiplied by any natural number. So see here, the multiples of 3 are 6, 9 and 12. Now factors and multiples are related to each other. See the example, 5 into 4 is equal to 20. So factors of 20 are 5 and 4, and multiples of 5 is what? 20. Same as multiple of 4 is 20. Now let's see what we conclude about factors and multiples. We can say 1 is a factor of every number. We can say that every number is a factor of itself. We can say every factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Every factor is less than or equal to the given number. Number of factors of a given number are finite. We find that every multiple of a number is greater than or equal to that number. We can find that the number of multiples of a given number is infinite. We can find that every number is a multiple of itself. Now, odd and even numbers. So the numbers in the pattern 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 are called as even numbers, or you can say the multiples of 2. Okay. Now the numbers in the pattern 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13 are called as odd numbers. Next is prime numbers. So a prime number is a number which has only two factors, which are 1 and the number itself. Let's see one example, like 5. Okay. So 5 has only two factors. One is a 5 and the second one is a 1. Okay, so 5 is a prime number. We can say 2 is the smallest even prime number. Next is composite numbers. So composite number is a opposite of prime number. Composite number have more than two factors. Okay, so we can see the numbers that have more than two factors are called as composite numbers. The number which is not prime is composite. Now scholars, let's see exercise 3.1, question number 1. So question number 1, write all the factors of the following numbers. First one is 24. So 24 is divisible by 1. We can write it 1 into 24 is equal to 24. Now 24 is divisible by 2 also. So we can write here 2 into 12 is equal to 24. Now by 3 also. So 3 into 8 is equal to 24. Now it is divisible by 4 also. So we can write it 4 into 6 is equal to 24. Now by 5, no, it is not divisible by 5. By 6, yes, 6 fours are 24. But already one time we have written 4 into 6. So the factors of 24 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12 and 24. Number B is 15. So this we can write 1 into 15 is equal to 15 because 15 is divisible by 1. Now 15 is divisible by 3 also. So 3 fives are 15. So 3 into 5 is equal to 15. Now by 4, no, it is not divisible by 4. By 5, yes, 5 threes are 15. But already one time we have written 3 into 5, okay. So the factors of 15 are 1, 3, 5 and 15. Next is 21. So first is 1 into 21 is equal to 21. Then it is divisible by 3. So 3 into 7 is equal to 21. So the factors of 21 are 1, 3, 7 and 21. Next one. See number E, 12. So factors of 12. It is divisible by 1 into 12 is equal to 12. By 2, so 2 into 6 is equal to 12. Now by 3 also, so 3 into 4 is equal to 12. Now by 4, so 4 into 3 is equal to 12. That already we have written one time. So the factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. So rest all try to do yourself. Okay. Now come to the question number 2. Write first 5 multiples of 5, 8 and 9. See the first one, 5. So the required multiples are 5 into 1 is equal to 5. 5 into 2 is equal to 10. 5 into 3 is equal to 15. 5 into 4 is equal to 20. 5 into 5 is equal to 25. So the first 5 multiples of 5 are 5, 10, 15, 20 and 25. Okay. We have to write first 5 multiples. That's why we are starting here from first. See the number B, it is 8. So the required multiples are 8 into 1 is equal to 8, 8 into 2 is equal to 16, 8 into 3 is equal to 24, 8 into 4 is equal to 32, 8 into 5 is equal to 40. So the first 5 multiples of 8 are 8, 16, 24, 32 and 40. Now let's see question number 3. Match the items in column 1 with the items in column 2. Column 1, 35, 15, 16, 20 and 25. Column 2, multiple of 8, multiple of 7, multiple of 70, factor of 30, factor of 50 and factor of 20. So first, 35 is a multiple of 7, means answer B. Next is 15, so 15 is a factor of 30, so answer number D. 16 is a multiple of 8, number A. Now 20 is a factor of 20, number F. Now 25, so 25 is a factor of 50, answer E. Come to the question number 4. Find all the multiples of 9 up to 100. So here we will write the multiples of 9. We will start from 1, means 9 into 1 is equal to 9. 9 into 2 is equal to 18. 9 into 3 is equal to 27. 9 into 4 is equal to 36. 9 into 5 is equal to 45. 9 into 6 is equal to 54. 9 into 7 is equal to 63. 9 into 8 is equal to 72. 9 into 9 is equal to 81. 9 into 10 is equal to 90. 9 into 11 is equal to 99. So all the multiples of 9 up to 100 are 9, 18, 27, 36, 45, 54, 63, 72, 81, 90 and 99. So scholars, your exercise 3.1 completed. Now let's see exercise 3.2. Question number 1 is, what is the sum of any two odd numbers, and the second one is even numbers. So see the first one, odd numbers. So the sum of any two odd numbers is even number. See the example, 5 plus 3. So 5 and 3 both are odd numbers and the total is coming 8. So 8 is even. See one more example, 15 plus 13. Here 15 and 13 both are odd number, but answer 28 is even number. See the second one, even numbers. So the sum of any two even numbers is even numbers. See the example, 2 plus 8 is equal to 10. 2 is even number, 8 is also even number, and the answer is also even number. See one more example, 12 plus 28 is equal to 40. So 12, 28 and answer 40, all are even numbers. 2, state whether the following statements are true or false. So this one, scholars, try to do yourself. See the question number 3. The numbers 13 and 31 are prime numbers. Both these numbers have same digits, 1 and 3. Find such pairs of prime numbers up to 100. Means up to 100, we have to find some numbers, and in that numbers, both the digits should be same. Okay. So see the prime numbers with same digits up to 100 are 17 and 71. So here 17, the digits are 1 and 7. And in 71, the digits are 7 and 1. Next one is 37. This we can write 73. Okay, 3 and 7 and 7 and 3 means the digits are same. Next one we can write 79 and 97. So 79 and 97, both numbers have the same digit. Question number 4. Write down separately the prime and composite numbers less than 20. Means less than 20, we have to find the prime numbers and the composite numbers. So scholars, means the number having exactly two factors, one and the number itself. The numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17 and 19 are the prime numbers less than 20. Now composite numbers means numbers having more than two factors. Okay, so 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 16, 15 and 18 are the composite numbers less than 20, and these numbers have more than two factors, so these numbers are called composite numbers. Next, question number 5. What is the greatest prime number between 1 and 10? So between 1 and 10, first we have to write all the prime numbers, means numbers which have only two factors. So first is 2, then 3, 5 and 7. These are the prime numbers between 1 and 10. So here 7 is the greatest prime number among them. Question number 6. Express the following as the sum of two odd primes, 44, 36, 24 and 18. So 44 we can write 3 plus 41. Okay, then 36, 2 prime numbers we have to write, means 7 plus 29 is equal to 36. Now 24, so 7 plus 17. Scholars, remember here we have to write prime numbers and the odd prime numbers. Okay, means prime numbers, those are odd prime. Okay, that we have to write here. So 7 plus 17 is equal to 24. And the last one, 18. 18 we can write 7 plus 11 is equal to 18. See the question number 7. Give 3 pairs of prime numbers whose difference is 2. And see the remark is given. 2 prime numbers whose difference is 2 are called twin prime numbers. It means the difference between prime numbers should be 2 only. Okay, let's see the solution. So the 3 pairs of prime numbers whose difference is 2 are 3 and 5, 5 and 7, 11 and 13. Same as scholars, you can write more prime numbers, okay, but here we have to write only 3. Come to the next question. Which of the following numbers are prime? So first one, 23, second is 51, third is 37, fourth one is 26. Okay, so to check numbers are prime numbers or not, we have to check the factors. Means if any number have only two factors, one and itself, so numbers are prime numbers. Okay, so first one is 23. So 23 is divisible by 1 and 23 only. So 23 has only two factors, 1 and 23. Hence it is a prime number. Next one is 51. So 51 is divisible by 3 and 17 also. Okay, so therefore 51 has 4 factors, 1, 3, 17 and 51. So hence it is not a prime number. It is a composite number. See the next one, 37. 37 is divisible by only 1 and 37. So 37 has 2 factors, 1 and 37. So it is a prime number. Next one is 26. 26. So scholars, 26 is an even number. Okay. So this have more than 2 factors. Like 1, it is divisible by 2 also, 13 also, and 26. So it is not a prime number. It is a composite number. Question number 9th. Write 7 consecutive composite numbers less than 100 so that there is no prime number between them. So 7 numbers are 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95 and 96. Consecutive composite numbers means there should be no gap and the number should be composite numbers. Okay, so you can see here these all 7 numbers have more than 2 factors. Okay, so it means these 7 numbers are consecutive composite numbers less than 100. Okay, come to the question number 10. Express each of the following numbers as the sum of 3 odd primes. So the number questions are 21, 31, 53 and 61. See the solution. We have to write 3 odd numbers. Means 3 odd prime numbers. So 21 we can write 3 plus 5 plus 13. All 3 numbers are odd number and prime also. Okay, 31. This we can write 3 plus 5 plus 23. So here also all the 3 numbers are odd and prime number. Then 53. Next is 53. This we can write 13 plus 17 plus 23. Last is 61. This we can write 7 plus 13 plus 41. Next, question number 11. Write 5 pairs of prime numbers less than 20 whose sum is divisible by 5. And hint is also given, 3 plus 7 is equal to 10. So see the solution. The 5 pairs of prime numbers less than 20 whose sum is divisible by 5 are. Means scholars, we have to write here 5 pairs of prime numbers and that number, the addition should be less than 20 and that addition means sum is divisible by 5. So the numbers are 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. 5 is divisible by 5. Second one, 2 plus 13, the sum is 15 and this is also divisible by 5. Next is 3 plus 17, sum is 20. 20 is also divisible by 5. Next, 7 plus 13, sum is 20. 20 is divisible by 5. And the last one is 19 plus 11, sum is 30. And 30 is also divisible by 5. So scholars, your exercise 3.2 also completed. For worksheet, you can see the link given in the description box. And scholars, stay at home and stay safe.